Hi, I'm Rob Shanley from Sargent Technical Services. Today, we will review one of our construction keying options, which is 21-dash lost ball method. This replaces the 22-dash or split key. This is used in all conventional key systems today. This feature protects the end user's permanent master key system, whereas we issue out temporary construction master keys. These are issued to the tradespeople for the construction part of the project. Once the job is completed, simply using the change or day keys in the locks and cylinders will void out the construction master key. This feature is accomplished in the key design phase by including either ball bearings or a small wafer in one of the six chambers. Also, the barrel or the plug of the cylinder is machined with two small holes or pockets to receive these ball bearings once the change keys are used. These ball bearings or wafer act as a master split, and this allows the construction master key to operate. Once the job is completed and ready to be turned over, simply by using the change key or day key in each of the cylinders, we'll position the ball bearings or wafer at the shear line. Then, when the key is turned, the ball bearings or wafer will fall into one of the prepared holes, thus voiding the construction master key. Now the end user has a peace of mind knowing that any construction master keys not collected during the project when it was completed will no longer operate the cylinders. In the key design phase, key records determines which chamber the balls will be loaded. And here we see the cylinder plug prepared to accept the balls when it comes time to drop. Here we see a cylinder plug machine ready to accept the 21-dash lost wafer when it comes time to drop it with the change key. Key records determines which chamber the wafer or balls will be installed into. Here they chose the fifth chamber. Now here's an overview of our 21-dash that's offered in our conventional fixed cylinders today. Let's look at a step-by-step on how it works. Here we see a line art of a cylinder prepared with the 21-dash balls loaded in one of the chambers with the change key inserted. Here we see what it looks like when the change key is inserted into the cylinder. Now the ball bearings are at the shear line. Now with the change key turned, it shows the ball bearings had fall into the prepared pocket. Now we see the change key rotated back to be removed. Now we see the change key removed with the ball bearings that have fallen into the pocket or hole, which will be there forever now. Here we see a degree cylinder prepared with the 21-dash, or in this case, lost wafer for construction keying. And it follows the same method as we saw at the 21-dash with the lost balls. Once the change key is used, the wafer will drop into a prepared pocket and the construction master key will never work. Now let's see how the 21 option works. Here's a cylinder loaded with the 21 option lost ball. Now here's my construction master key. You see she operates. Now once the change key is used, or day key, and you rotate it, those ball bearings will be at the shear line and will fall into one of those holes or prepared pockets. Now once the change key is used, the construction master key will still enter, but it won't turn because those balls have fallen. Here the lost ball is shown for comparison size next to a key. They're about the size of a ballpoint pen. We load 4 per cylinder for the 21-dash option. And that's how the 21-dash construction feature operates and or works. For more information, contact us at sergeantlock.com. Call us at 800-727-5477 or email us at techsupport.sergeant@asaabloy.com.